Hey everyone, welcome back to Architecture for Thought. We're seeing a lot of AI-generated content recently that is heavily focused on aesthetics only, which is understandable since programs such as Midjourney are image-based generators. But I wanted to offer some thoughts on architecture that may help refocus your AI pursuits, or at least offer a new perspective on how I believe the practice of Western architecture needs to evolve. I am getting more interested in organic architectures that can be produced using 3D printing or formwork with adobe, mud, terracotta, other organic mixtures, cob and hay being used as sort of the binding element in some of these mixtures. So I'm starting to explore more architectures that have a good balance between modern or even a futuristic lean with very ancient maybe building techniques that are making a comeback because they have sort of they do have good qualities in terms of sustainability and earth friendliness, but I think there's a lot of benefits to them as well in terms of our health, our mental health, and these things need to really find their way into the architectural profession. We need to make a way that they can become normalized and people can feel comfortable, being in a home with mud walls. But I got a lot of funny comments about some of the organic images I was producing early on with Midjourney. Some comments were like, drywallers are going to hate this guy. No one can drywall arches like that for an economical price. And that's true. I mean, I think if anyone, has tried to do curved architecture, they've probably run into the issue of finding contractors or good contractors, good builders that understand how to do curved geometry. So we're starting to lean on technologies that can do some of that for us to replace the lost art of building curved organic geometries that, was simpler to produce with something like a mud or adobe hut where you literally built it with your hands and some formwork, and it was okay if the geometry wasn't perfect. But the expectations of everyone nowadays is that the geometry needs to be perfect. My walls need to be clean. It needs to, look Instagram worthy. And so if we're producing something that's below that quality level, it's going to resemble something of a third world country. Well, I would argue that the future needs to resemble that, so that, for many reasons, one being it can and should be more economical, especially if we have technology assisting us build these geometries. Number two, it's okay to see deviations and, some character in the architectures that we build. I don't think we need to have these Lego box architectures. We have had that, and we do have that with a lot of elements like metal panels and these kind of prefabricated architectural components to make our buildings look and seem like building kits, like Lego kits. And I don't think it's a good thing. I don't think, we don't originate from that type of mechanized or robotized aesthetic. We originate from images like this, that they're organic, they're typically near a water source. They were, generated from the earth, from the mud that is around us. Again, there's a lot of building techniques that we've lost in terms of cooling and heating a home, orientation of a home based on the sun path or the winds, or if you're building adjacent to a mountain range, you know, how the winds and weather patterns may affect that. And we don't use a lot of those things in our architectural concepts anymore, because we're either typically building a residential home that's on a suburban block that has to face a certain way because that's where the lot is, or there's a commercial development that needs to maximize the square footage in terms of leasable real estate for tenants so that the developer can make their money back. And these are the driving forces now of architecture, not these sort of native approaches that keep and kept us in tune with and in touch with the earth. And if you're still listening to this, I guess I'm going to make this an episode to introduce the conversion of this channel into what I'm calling Architecture for Thought, which is going to promote a new way to look at architecture. It's going to explore how technology can influence architecture to move back towards a in-tune aesthetic and mode of operation with the earth. And I think that's the possible future that I want to promote and that we should be living in, just based on what we're seeing in the world with people's health, with the cost of manufactured elements. This channel will focus on creating architecture that can be beautiful, that can be healthy, that can be available to all, because we are building with the elements of the earth and we are using technologies that are affordable now and understood by many in, you know, prior generations and generations to come. So thanks for sticking with me, and I appreciate your interest in this channel, in my architectural concepts, and hopefully you will enjoy the content that is to come.